Hi there, welcome back to the Scriptcase Macros course. My name is Nate Carpenter, I'm the Scriptcase instructor leading this course. And in this video, we're looking at the SC button disable macro. So this macro, as it says here, allows us to disable a button on the menu. So this is only on the menu, but allows us to disable it so it can't be clicked. So as you can see here, here's the documentation. Pretty simple, we just need to pass through the button ID, we'll look at how to get that, and then on or off. So off to disable it and on to enable it. So we're going to do this on a menu on one of the events here. So as you can see, I have a menu here. This is just a basic menu. And if I go here to the menu items, I have these here, but these are not the buttons. These are just the menu items. And then if I go to toolbar, I have a button put on here, an exit button, as you can see, and I could add more buttons if I wanted. And as you can see right there, button underscore one is that button ID. So now I'm going to go to events and then the on load event. And I can put that code in here. So this is going to be button one was the ID of that, and then it's going to be off. And actually, let me comment this out here first, so that you can see this button enabled first, so you can see what it looks like before and after. Get an A case and then a B case. So let me run this. So there's that exit button right there below the menu item there. So that's the button that we are disabling. So let's go back now and disable that button. So back here, and we're going to uncomment that line now. And now we run this, and it should disable that button. So it displays the text, but we can't click it or anything. It doesn't look like a button even. So as you can see, there is our button right there that has been disabled. So that's how you use the SC button disable macro to disable a button on the menu.